Hey guys, it's the AC3Follower here, back with part 3 of my Minecraft Let's Play, still building the Auditore Villa, also known as Montregioni, from Assassin's Creed 2. Now in this Let's Play, we're going to be continuing its construction, building the battlements, so the towers along the walls, as well as something else that's a bit special that'll be built at the end of the Let's Play. So let's start off first, though, by looking at exactly what we're trying to reconstruct here in Montregioni by looking at Assassin's Creed 2. So as you can see, as Ezio runs along the battlements of Montregioni from Assassin's Creed 2, there are three towers along the side walls, both sides, and then there's three at the front, one big one at the center that's already been constructed. But because my Montregioni is not to complete scale, I'll be building still the three on either side, but I'll only have the one larger one in the center. I do not have room for the two on either side of it, so I will not have them in my construction in Minecraft. But that's alright. I've been spending a lot of time building this, mainly gathering resources. A few of you who have joined and seen the world and seen the construction that's been going on, I try to leave as much as I can to recording, which sometimes is, you know, a bit annoying, you know, when I'm just playing and I feel like constructing, but I need to wait till I'm kind of, you know, sitting around recording. This, you know, in Montregioni you see things like all the flags and all that kind of stuff. If anyone has any ideas of an idea of how I could build the flags that are, you know, above everything, you know, just leave that in the comments below. And the other thing at the end of the last one I'm going to be constructing is the well, but it's going to be a special twist on the well that you'll see at the end that I'll be putting into the villa itself. So now we're here on Montregioni on my Minecraft world, and I will start constructing the battlements along the walls of Montregioni. As I go through doing that, I'll talk about a couple things. First of all, the different buildings I plan on building after Montregioni. I've decided on all of them. There'll be one from every game of Assassin's Creed, Assassin's Creed 1, 2, Brotherhood, Revelations, and once 3 comes out, I'll decide on something for 3. I'm not really planning to make it surprises, I'll just tell you what I'm planning to build. I've found the locations on this world, I'm building everything on this world that I built Montregioni on. So I'm building, secondly, straight after this, I'm building Tibber Island. I've already started Tibber Island, the kind of base center for, you know, the shape of it and everything. And that's from Assassin's Creed Brotherhood. That's the next thing I'll be building. After that, from Assassin's Creed Revelations, I'll be constructing Galata Tower. That won't be as long as Tibber Island or Montregioni, but the final thing I'm constructing, I think, will probably take maybe just as long as Montregioni, probably not, because I already have quite a lot of resources. I'll be building Masyaf Castle from the first Assassin's Creed game, which is also in Assassin's Creed Revelations, the main headquarters for the Assassin Order in those games. So those are the three things I got planned after Montregioni. You know, I'm really excited to get into building those. It's going to be a lot of work, but I've got a lot of time to build it. There's no rush for me to construct all the buildings. I'm just going to, you know, build it as I go, take it slow. And I know lots of you, well, a few of you have been joining some of my Minecraft matches. Now, if either I don't invite you, like you may message me and want to get, you know, build on Minecraft and I don't reply, it's not because I am annoyed or I don't want to have help. I just, especially when I'm building, and especially Montregioni because I've been doing it for so long, it's something I really would like to do on my own. I like your input, but when it comes to construction, it's something I would prefer to do on my own. If you want to have a look at it, that's fine. But also when it comes to just Xbox in general, because I know a lot of you have added me on Xbox Live, which is awesome. I don't mind that. I won't accept everyone. I try to accept as many people as I can, but some people I won't. Don't take it personally, and if I don't want to join a match with you at any time on Xbox Live, don't take it personally either. I'm a person that, ask any of my friends, it's not just you guys, like any of my friends, I don't join their parties either. I'm a person who loves playing Xbox, in my own kind of zone. When I'm playing things like Assassin's Creed, I'm not going to join a party. If I'm playing multiplayer, sure, I'll join a party. If I'm playing story mode for any of these Assassin's Creed games, I'm not going to join parties. Nothing personal, it's just I don't do it. I'm in my zone of just playing. I like getting immersed in any story I'm playing, whether I played it 13 times like Assassin's Creed 2 or I played it once like other games, you know, it doesn't really change. It's just, that's just how I work when I play video games. Nothing personal, but that's just, you know, what happens when I'm playing, and I won't accept everyone's sorry. And I may end up deleting some people. It's nothing personal, because I enjoy all your feedback, I enjoy talking to all of you. You can message me, and I'll message back still, but, you know, there's only a certain amount of people you can have on your friends list, so I want to save that for people I know, but also some people that will end up playing lots of Assassin's Creed 3 multiplayer with me, not just when Assassin's Creed just comes out and then you'll get over it, but, you know, people who are big fans or any other games, I don't know, like Halo 4 and things like that. So, you know, nothing personal, that's just how it works on Xbox. What else? Also, I've been making a lot of plans for the future for the channel. The future of the channel, once Assassin's Creed 3 comes out and I've done the walkthrough and I've done all the videos I want to do for it, I can talk about my plans later on. It's all good news. I'm always going to keep doing YouTube videos, I think, for a long time to come. Whether it's on this channel or I make another channel that's not all Assassin's Creed based, I don't know. I haven't really decided that. I'm thinking of later on, you know, end of the year, maybe start next year, starting up a new channel. Still doing videos for this channel, of course, but for other things like that can just be all types of games, not limited to Assassin's Creed. I don't want this channel to be limited to Assassin's Creed, but it's called AC3Follower. I've kind of put myself into that little box where I can't really do much else, which is fine because Assassin's Creed is my favourite game. If I had to do those, play any game forever, it would be Assassin's Creed, so I'm not that concerned about it, but, you know, that's just something to note to you guys. Now, back to kind of Minecraft stuff. I'm still doing the battlements right now. The village is going well. It's the west side of the villa. The villa itself that I haven't done many of the buildings. I've done the brothel and the barracks and some of the shops in the center, but I haven't done, you know, the buildings that connect up. Many of you can tell, you know, if you've played Assassin's Creed 2. It's not to scale, but it's, you know, it's there. It's the main buildings that are prominent through the game, and then some other connecting buildings that, you know, make sense to put in there so it looks enough like it. I'm going to do as many of the landmarks as I can. I'm putting the well in. The mine's out the back. I mean, it's not like... In the side, trust me, it does not look like the mine from the game. It is much bigger because I've been digging all my resources out of it. I've got... If I ever look over, I'm not sure, into the distance outside Montregioni. Out the front of it, to the left, you can see the lights just there in the top right just a second ago. That's my landmark placement where I placed where I'm going to be building the next couple of buildings. Galata Tower is where that one was. Then I've got Tibber Island off in the distance further, and I've got Marcia, if I'm building that up in the snowy area, the only snowy point in my world. I know lots of you have said, you know, it looks a bit grey. Yeah, I know. I mean, I thought about sandstone, but I didn't really like the idea too much. I thought about it, and I know that the Minecraft update for Xbox is coming out soon, but I really don't want to have to redo everything by putting stone blocks. When it comes to Tibber Island and other things, yeah, then I can do that, but Mondragione is going to stay pretty much using cobblestone. That's just how it's going to stay for... pretty much everything. You can see the distance over there, that little island with the light on it. That's where Galata Tower is going to be built. That's a better view of it. I put the torches out so you could see it. Well, I could see it better, so I know exactly where it was. I've got signs out. Some of you have seen the signs I put out saying, you know, Galata Tower coming soon, Tibber Island coming soon, and everything. So yeah, it's all very exciting. Got lots planned for Minecraft. Lots planned for lots of other games, you know. By the end of the year, I really don't know how I'm going to get any of my schoolwork done. when Assassin's Creed 3 comes out, but, you know, I'll try my best. Because I want to get my Assassin's Creed walkthrough up as fast as I can. But if it's going a little slow at any point, it's because I literally cannot play the game. Because I'm a person who tries to focus on school as much as I can. I don't play Xbox all the time. I really only play on weekends. That's the only time I play Xbox. I try to play as much as I can, but then, you know, I have school, I have work, I have lots of other commitments. But I, you know, I do try to play as much as I can, because I'd rather play Xbox than really do anything else. Here's me actually fixing up this battlement, because I completely screwed it up. It was facing the wrong direction. I had the views facing off into the right, but I needed to go straight out. So that was a bit of a mix-up. Anyway, back to what I was saying, if the walkthrough is a bit slow, sorry, I'll try to put it out really as fast as I can. Realistically, if I'm going to play Assassin's Creed 3 for a long period of time, I'll probably end up going like 6 hours straight, and that'll give me a lot of parts of the walkthrough, hopefully, to last me, because my goal really when Assassin's Creed 3 comes out is to play, I'd say, spend one day in the weekend just playing as much of the day as I can, and that'll be pretty much 30 parts of a walkthrough right there that I can upload as the week progresses, and then by the time I've run out of uploads, it'll be the day where I'm playing again and I'll record it all. And I'm not just going to be doing the main story. I'll end up going off doing the side missions, of course, like the multiplayer, but I'm going to leave multiplayer, even though I love multiplayer, I'm really going to be leaving that till way later, because I want to finish the complete single player mode and really get every single achievement before I even touch multiplayer. So lots of you are looking forward to multiplayer, sorry, that's the last thing really I'm looking at. But as you can see here, I'm building the well, and this is the special thing I'm doing for this Let's Play. So I'm building a ladder at the back of Montreal Journey now to go up to fell down, screwed that up like a retard. Climb up here onto the roof, because I built a little Leap of Faith perch. So I can just fall down or jump off after I synchronize down into the little well. So I'm using the well as kind of my Leap of Faith point. So guys, that's this Let's Play of Minecraft. Hope you guys enjoyed that. It's been fun building, and I'll have more, really, in the future. I think the next Let's Play will be the last Montreal Journey Let's Play, where I finish everything off, finish the buildings on the west side and everything like that, and get all that done. So that'll be about it for Montreal Journey, then I'll start Let's Plays for Tibber Island after that. Thanks guys for watching, please like, favorite, and subscribe to help the channel grow, and to get the latest AC3 news and updates. Thanks guys, I will see you later.